the mighty Mosasaurus returns in Jurassic World Rebirth. Sporting a more paleo-informed redesign, gone is the oversized, scoot-covered kaiju beast of the previous films, and in its place, we find a sleeker, less crocified marine reptile. While this new Mosasaurus pays far better homage to the real animal than the one from the previous trilogy, what is shown on screen is still different from what we see in the fossil record. So in this video, we'll explore how scientifically accurate the Jurassic World Rebirth Mosasaurus really is, and compare it to what paleontologists now know about the actual animal. We will then speculate on what went into the DNA of this clone to make it look the way it does. Now without further ado, let's dive in. For starters, let's give credit where credit is due. Jurassic World Rebirth gets a surprising amount right about Mosasaurus. The new Mosasaurus has much more realistic proportions. The long, streamlined body, powerful paddle-like limbs, and a robust tail give it a silhouette that closely matches fossil-based reconstructions of Mosasaurus hoffmanni. Another detail that is easy to miss, but impressive for those locked into paleontology, is the inclusion of pterygoid teeth. These are an additional set of teeth on the roof of the mouth that helped real mosasaurs grip slippery prey like fish and ammonites. They would then use this extra set of teeth to further process the prey items down their throats. Unfortunately, we don't get a good view of these teeth in action, but at least official renders confirm that the teeth were present. This Mosasaurus is also countershaded, dark on top, lighter underneath, just like many modern marine predators. This is a textbook example of camouflage in open water, and is something we'd fully expect in the real animal. This is even further supported by fossil evidence, which you can learn more about in my previous Mosasaurus video. While the lighter side of the animal is close to what we see in the fossil record, the darker portion isn't too far off either. The upper darker side is made up of shades of green, brown, and dark grays. While the browns and dark grays are more within the realm of possibility, green is much less likely. The animal also has an interesting spotted pattern, almost akin to tiger sharks. While there isn't direct fossil evidence for patterns like this in mosasaurs, it's not entirely out of the realm of possibilities. The tail is no longer that awkward crocodilian taper. Instead, we now see a proper tail fluke, exactly what fossil evidence suggests mosasaurs had for propulsion. Rather than being made of feature scales like the previous movie monster, the Jurassic World Rebirth Mosasaurus has a tail fluke made entirely of soft tissue. This is by far my favorite inclusion of the redesign, and it's an extra layer of menace every time the Mosasaurus slowly breaches the surface, with its tail fluke poking out of the water like a shark fin. And finally, gone is the bumpy crocodile skin from earlier films. The previous Mosasaurus had osteoderms and crocodilian-like scutes and feature scales all across its back. The new Mosasaurus features smoother, scaly skin, which is much more aligned with preserved skin impressions from mosasaur fossils. It's interrupted only by one odd addition, but we'll get to that in a bit. Now with all of that out of the way, let's take a look into the inaccuracies, where the Jurassic World designers took several creative liberties that break from the science. For starters, the Jurassic World Rebirth Mosasaurus is still far too large. Even the largest known Mosasaurus hoffmanni fossils top out at about 17 meters or 56 feet. The creature in Rebirth appears to be over 100 feet long, putting it firmly in kaiju territory. The head alone appears to be over half as large as a real-life Mosasaurus. And speaking of the head, the skull shape appears to be quite shrink-wrapped, with the bones visibly outlined under thin skin. In reality, soft tissue would have given the head a bulkier appearance, especially around the jaw muscles and nasal passages. There is also an extended bony protrusion above the eyes, giving it a more exaggerated look for dramatic flair. While the previous Jurassic World Mosasaurus was completely lipless, Jurassic World Rebirth's Mosasaurus is actually partially lipless. The larger teeth towards the front of the snout are exposed, while the smaller teeth further back are covered. However, given the skull anatomy and the evolutionary history of these animals, with their closest living relatives being animals like monitor lizards, Mosasaurus would have been fully lipped instead. and the teeth of the real animal would not be exposed like they are in the movie. Now, while the Jurassic World Rebirth Mosasaurus no longer has crocodilian-like scutes, feature scales, and osteoderms, it does have rows of round, bumpy osteoderm-like nodules running down its back. There's no fossil evidence that Mosasaurus had anything like that. Some artistic license is understandable, but these only further separate the movie monster from the real-life marine reptile. Even stranger are the humpback whale-like ventral pleats, those accordion-like folds along the underside. These pleats are a feature of baleen whales, which use them to help expand their throat during filter feeding. Mosasaurs were reptiles, not mammals, and had no such adaptation. Furthermore, they were definitely not filter feeders. Beyond just the appearances, there are even some behavioral and biomechanical inaccuracies at play here. Now, evidence shows that Mosasaurus can do something known as a C-start to accelerate at great speeds. They would use this to quickly lunge themselves towards prey and even breach the water. The impact alone would be enough to kill most animals, including sea turtles and plesiosaurs, but to do the acrobatic twirl-like motion seen in the film is not in line with the kind of breaching Mosasaurus would have been capable of. Lastly, the idea of Mosasaurus cooperating with the Spinosaurus squad, while fun, is pure science fiction. Not only did these animals live in completely different ecosystems, but they were also separated by millions of years. One lived in the seas of the late Cretaceous, the other stocked freshwater river systems and estuaries of North Africa over 20 million years before Mosasaurus splashed onto the scene. And one more thing, Mosasaurus is not a dinosaur. Shame on you, Dr. Loomis, you should know better. So now that we have gone over all the inaccuracies, let's speculate on what went into the DNA of the Jurassic World Rebirth Mosasaurus. For starters, we'll be using Mosasaurus hoffmanni as the base genome. This was the largest species of Mosasaurus known to exist, and it is the closest anatomical match to the film version. As usual, InGen's go-to filler, frog DNA, was likely used in the creation of this animal. Modern monitor lizards and sea snakes are some of the closest living relatives to Mosasaurus. Adding genes from these reptiles could have helped further stabilize the animal's genome. Now, Mosasaurus and most other Mesozoic marine reptiles did not have a row of knobby osteoderms running down its spine, but there is one species that did. A bizarre early Triassic species of marine reptile known as a Rhytomorhynchus. This platypus-looking like reptile had a single row of round osteoderms running down its back. While not related to Mosasaurus, perhaps InGen used DNA from this animal to justify the spiny dorsal aesthetic, whether for function or just for flair. But even this inclusion is less out there compared to the next two animals. The Ganges River dolphin has a unique facial structure with reduced lips and a long, narrow snout. Its perpetually exposed teeth and mostly lipless grin may have inspired the partially lipped, snarling appearance of the Rebirth Mosasaurus. And finally, the most obvious influence, the humpback whale. The ventral pleats along the Mosasaurus's underside are a clear whale trait, completely foreign to reptiles. The inclusion of humpback whale DNA could have also explained its unusual acrobatic moves and may help contribute to the clone being oversized. And there we have it, our speculative genetic makeup for the Rebirth Mosasaurus. Again, none of this is officially canon to the franchise, but was done so as a fun way to differentiate between the fantasy of Jurassic World and the reality of the fossil record. Jurassic World Rebirth's Mosasaurus is far from perfect, but it's honestly a step in the right direction. It corrects many of the flaws of past depictions and gets closer to honoring the true terror of the ancient Cretaceous seas. But it still takes creative liberties, because Hollywood. Still, we can't help but admire how this cinematic beast bridges the gap between science and storytelling, keeping Mosasaurus in the well-deserved spotlight and reminding us of the amazing sea creatures that once ruled the oceans. And for what it's worth, it definitely stacks better than the previous Jurassic World Mosasaurus did. Be sure to check out my previous comparison video, where I give a much more detailed look into the real-life Mosasaurus as well. As always, thanks for watching.